Your turn.
Thanks, douchebag.
Welcome to Button Jam.
This
is Brian.
This is Donny.
And we are going to review what I have already stated is one of my very favorite games, Vanquish, for the PlayStation 3.
Good old Vanquish.
Vanquish. Bop you.
Bangkok.
I'm just gonna jump right into it because I love this game so much.
It's a good game.
This game is fun. I wanna just take a moment, you know, take away the story, cinematics, graphics, everything like that. When I play this game, I get elated.
I mean, I'm gonna just go ahead and say, if you haven't played it, play it. If you've not even heard of it, you don't know anything about it, go watch our friggin' Let's Play. Just taste it. Just have a taste.
It's so good.
It's good. It's very umami.
It's... What?
What? Like, the fucking... You know what? This is not a good time to get into how dumb of a word that is.
Okay. I want to say that, like, there's a lot of things that come together to make it a very fun game for me. For one thing, the weapon variety.
Yes.
We didn't explore a lot of that during our Let's Play, but...
Well, we did eventually.
Yes.
It's hard to find... like problems that were not solved by a heavy machine gun or repeated shotguns to something's face.
Yeah, if you really go through the wide variety in that game, you get things like the lock-on laser, which locks on to multiple targets and then, you know, fires lasers into the air that land on your opponents, or there's
the disc launcher, which I only discovered its majesty toward the end.
Yes.
Of, like, damn near homing buzzsaw blades.
That hit at least two enemies at once.
Yeah, that just, like, bounce off of people and hit other things. Like, damn.
Things like there was actually free DLC for this game.
Was there?
It included three weapons, and that was it. I don't even remember what they are.
We should have grabbed that.
Yeah.
She would have told me before we started.
I know. It completely slipped my mind until it was far, far too late. The LFE gun is terrible.
Well,
it just releases like a shockwave, and like I don't know what it hits because like I fired it directly at enemies and they don't fall down.
Maybe it just does damage and not. Like recoil.
I never thought of that.
Yeah.
Anyway, so that's weapon variety. There was a lot of that.
There was.
And there was, of course, the fast-paced action, that intensity.
Oh yeah.
Oh my goodness. I mean,
which I had to. Honestly, like, I'm not the best at shooters, and to keep up, I had to abuse the friggin'...
The slowdown mechanic.
Yeah, the little bullet time mode
to
just keep up with it all.
Yeah. Normally you wanna...
It's so much. There's just so much going on at every point.
There really is.
Every corner of the map is so dense.
I'm gonna beat you.
It's true, though. There are enemies everywhere. There are allies all over the place.
Dying.
You are in a war zone.
Oh, yes.
You are some kind of Superman with a shotgun in a war zone between man and machine and occasionally, well...
Really big machine.
Occasionally really big machines and somewhat toward the end, just you versus man.
You versus... The everything.
Spoiler on that.
Yeah.
But seriously, go fucking watch the Let's Play. Stop watching this. Go watch the Let's Play. Come back.
Actually, we won't wait.
we're gonna keep going.
Yeah, but...
But you can pause this. It's the magic of the internet.
Yeah. And there was something that I actually didn't know about during my entire playthrough, that I didn't do for the show, but I did years ago, was the sliding drop kick. I really wish I had known about that long ago, because then I would have been able to pull off even more crazy maneuvers. This game is so over the top, just so outrageous in the amount of things you can do.
It's a platinum game.
It's very much a platinum game. It's, you know, you take the Devil May Cry formula and you throw guns and jet boots onto it.
Yeah, you know what? It's kind of like if Gears of War was done, I gotta stop accidentally, like, tapping the mic.
Yeah.
It's like if Gears of War was done by the Platinum team. You have, like, the cover mechanics, you have your duck shoot, you have, you know, you can get into things' faces, and, I mean, come on, you got the disc launcher, yeah. And it's basically...
It's a chainsaw gun.
Yeah.
That is something that I want to mention.
And then they threw friggin', like, you know, super power slidey rocket boots into it because it's platinum, and just having a regular fucking shooter was not enough.
Absolutely. But I do want to say though, that Western influence is clear. This game is, at its core, a cover shooter.
Yes.
And that is. That's like almost completely just unseen from the Japanese market, not market, just
they're not,
unseen from
they're not
Japanese developers.
Typically known for developing shooters in general.
There's that too. They usually don't do shooters, and even less often they do cover shooters. And this one was just knocked it out of the park.
Oh yeah.
It's really a beautiful game too. On top of that, it's very, very slick. The amount of detail that you see on Sam's suit.
Oh yeah. And then like, we didn't take a whole lot of like just taking a moment to enjoy the scenery, but damn, like someone developed a fucking world that is in a space satellite. Like a fucking space colony that has, like, you know, friggin' green areas and a cityscape, and it's so nice to look at. It's surprisingly beautiful. And we didn't take a whole lot of movement to chew the scenery, so to speak.
But there was a lot to there was a lot
more,
to bite off
in a more literal sense than the typical. Acting metaphor.
Yeah.
But
I think if there is something else that I want to mention. Very prevalent in this game. And to think we were even on the lower settings, it's hard.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Definitely a challenge.
And just that unbelievable moment, like Donny played the game on medium, and in some stages died so often that he had a negative score.
that might just be being shit, though.
Maybe.
That could be me being shit.
Maybe, but, you know, there are still numerous one-hit-kill enemies. There are things like the robots that will start glowing and then crawling towards you, and if they explode, you're dead. You get hit by a grenade, you're dead. You get hit by a blast from Romanov's head.
There's not a whole lot of instant kills, but they are there.
Yeah.
And some of them are boss-related or, like, mini-boss-related.
The unknown.
Yeah, the friggin'... Oh, God, the unknown. And the unknown and it's friggin' ripping you apart. The friggin',
The Romanov drill.
Yeah, the Romanov drilling you to pieces. Like... You could tell that Shinji Mikami was a part of this because there are those, like, Resident Evil 4 style, like, oh, this regular-ass enemy activated its cinematic kill on you.
Yeah, and usually that was in the form of when they would jump on you. Of course, we never actually saw that kill, because you always got through the quick time to end up jamming it onto the ground and then ripping its torso off.
Yes.
Fortunate. Very fortunate.
Yeah. I don't know. When you have time to quick times, when the quick times aren't quick, I'm okay.
It actually breaks my heart that this was Shinji Mikami's only project, only directorial project at Platinum Games.
Yeah.
And I really wish he would go back and make Vanquish 2.
Yeah. It's a damn shame we'll never see a Vanquish 2. It's kind of a damn shame, like, Evil Within fucking murdered that guy's motivation to do video games in general these days. I'm so mad at Bethesda for that. I cannot, as much as, like, I am a Bethesda fan, I am appalled to hear that. Like, how could they have treated a legend like him so poorly that he decided to quit developing games? That's frustrating that we will never see another AAA fucking hallmark of a friggin' Shinji Mikami game.
Yeah.
And I see this game and I see his influences on it, and I'm like, this is a great game. No one played a whole lot of this, and between, like, this not being a success and friggin',
Evil Within?
Evil Within being the travesty that it became.
Not, like, to mention, like, let's look at the differences between the original Resident Evil, his love child, basically, and what it is now.
Yeah. Like, that guy is a great director.
Absolutely.
Producer?
Game director. Whatever. He's a great developer.
Yeah. And it's really sad to see, like, how underappreciated he is for being such a legend, you know?
Like you can, like, people tout his name all they want, but, you know, you're not gonna find a whole lot of people playing Vanquish. A lot of people would rather play the later Resident Evil games than the original Resident Evil. People will like criticize Resident Evil for its backgrounds, for its gameplay style. It is stiff, but yeah. it
just suffers from that age, basically. Which is, you know, I mean, I hate to say it, like, we did not fucking enjoy Dino Crisis much. I didn't, at least.
Yeah, but Donnie, of course, referring to the age, not to Shinji Mikami. We know Shinji Mikami wasn't involved with Dino Crisis 2.
Yeah. It's just that age, that PlayStation age of gaming.
And right.
It's not his fault. That's just pretty much how games played back then.
Yeah.
Resident Evil, Silent Hill, fucking Dino Crisis. There were a lot of those little tank control kind of games.
Yeah.
But that aside,
There is hope, I think. It's just, you know, it's a candle in the distance, basically, because if you look at it one way. Yes, it's true, Shinji Mikami is no longer involved with Platinum Studios. However, Atsuhi Inaba was involved in the production of this game, and Atsuhi Inaba is also a director at Platinum Games, and we've seen games at Platinum be directed in a series, be directed by two different people. For instance, Hideki Kamiya directed the first Bayonetta game. He did not direct the second. In fact, I believe Atsuhi Inaba took care of Bayonetta 2.
Which we've not played, though.
We have not.
Sadly. We own, we tried, we were gonna do it, but friggin', as far as doing it for the show, fucking, our We have to own up to it.
Our motivation is shot.
Yeah, we don't know if we'll ever resume that because I'm so disappointed in Sega as far as like how they're handling their YouTube copyright.
Yeah,
like it's terrible.
I'm surprised we got away with this because this was Vanquish was part of Sega and Platinum's five game deal.
Yeah.
I'm surprised we got this. Maybe it's because Bayonetta was hot and Vanquish was not.
I guess they want to milk that fucking Bayonetta money, but they didn't find it necessary with Vanquish, I guess.
Yeah. Which is, you know, once again, I really want to touch on that. The shame of the lack of sales, even despite the critical, like, the critical reception that Vanquish got.
Yeah.
Like,
again, bringing it back, one of, it got the award, the most oh shit moments. I was thinking there was, the greatest game no one's played or something.
Yeah, I forgot about that one.
Yeah.
It did get that award. Best game that no one played.
Yeah, that's
Which is really a shame. It broke 1 million sales at the end of last year.
Yeah, that makes me so sad.
And this game came out years ago.
So many years.
Yeah.
I mean, Bayonetta 1 age, so 2009, something like that, I think. Yeah. I forget. We looked it up before. Yeah, but
we did. Whatever. It was still just such a fantastic game that just got... I mean, it's not even just that it got poor, you know... It's not just a poor advertising campaign in the United States. Nobody played it in Japan either.
Yeah.
I don't know why. Maybe because once again, mentioning the Western influence.
That could be. Japan... shooters just aren't popular in Japan.
Yeah.
That's all we have to look at there. As far as Western, I mean, Platinum was not that big when they first started.
They...
Other than Bayonetta, like, their initial games were not hits.
Yeah.
Bayonetta was their first big hit.
It was. It was a big runaway hit, but, like, you know, things like Mad World, Anarchy Reigns, Infinite Space, those things just did not take off the same way Bayonetta did.
Anarchy Reigns was so... it was a disappointment of a game.
Yeah. Mad World was probably another title that deserved more than it got.
I don't know. It suffered the Wii sales kind of thing.
But yeah, I mean, like, I feel like stronger marketing could have helped this game, especially in the United States. Definitely in the United States.
That's another thing. Didn't hear a whole lot of, like, I don't think any of their games were really highly marketed.
No, they were not.
I mean, so partially to fault of their own, really.
Yeah, Mad World got a review on X-Play, I remember that.
Yeah. Well, for all good, that does anything.
Yeah.
I feel like if Vanquish had been better marketed, or that is to say marketed at all, it probably would have been a lot better accepted. Or, I mean, it would have probably sold better is what I mean.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it was plenty well received.
Yeah, it was, I mean...
to those who actually played it.
You just look at that game and it's like, other than, you know, maybe you have like, if you're someone who doesn't like shooters in general, then maybe, yeah, I could see you look at this and it's like, it's just more shooting dudes and it's like very plain looking. Because honestly, most of the time, unless you do take that moment to absorb the scenery, it's just you're fighting in this like grayish white friggin' world of metal.
Yeah, that is something about Vanquish. It's a lot more colorful than shooters in its genre.
Yeah.
I mean, there is you still see all these like clones. Soldiers. I mean, obviously not literal clones, but they all pretty much use the same model, except for, of course, Burns. And all the enemies are actually the same
friggin' red robot looking thing.
But if you like, but that's the thing though. You're not shooting like a gray robot. You're shooting a bright red robot.
Yeah.
You are shooting a bright red robot that explodes blue.
I gotta say, I remember friggin' all of the soldiers wearing green and thinking... I never said it. I never thought to say it for some reason. But, it's like, you're wearing, like, this green kind of camo color in space on a satellite.
Yeah.
Like, friggin' Sam and his fucking metal armor blends in better than the friggin' soldiers. But, I mean, I guess, you know, just generic soldier wear, because their enemies are fucking robots, and therefore
it's
not
gonna matter.
Yeah.
Like, infrared vision and whatever.
So much so, oh man, I love that smoking to mechanic. Not just, like, a taunt button, either.
It's not fire diversion. It's very brief, but it actually diverts their fire.
Yeah. It's not like, you know, typical friggin' video game where they work in a smoking mechanic and it, like, calms your nerves or whatever. It's like, no, he just fucking lights up, takes a smoke, and the fucking enemies shoot at the friggin' bright red thing because they're like, heat signature!
They're like, oh, we goofed. Oh, there's a man with a rocket launcher over there. Oh, we made a mistake.
The one thing I didn't like while we're on the topic of mechanics and heat is the friggin' overheating. Like, I get it to an extent where it's like, okay, well, you can't just slow down time forever. You can't just rocket boots forever. But really, melee attacks overheating the system?
And that horrible just wow, 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 wow.
Oh yeah,
every
I got
time.
So sick of hearing that. Especially, like, eventually, as you would figure, and I actually liked that there were attacks and stuff that, like, oh yeah, you got basically set on fire.
Yeah.
Of course your suit is overheating, and it's gotta take a moment to put out the flames.
Right.
Sure.
Or you're just, like, too close to the exhaust jets of the walking, you know, behemoth.
Yeah. Stuff like that, you know, that all makes sense. I forgot my point.
Overheating.
Yeah, but I forgot what I was trying to say about it.
You hate it.
Yeah,
you understand it, but you hate it.
Yeah,
The frequency and I think they could have benefited from a larger cooldown bar
or something, or like a way to decrease the cooldown as time went on. Like, you had the ability to upgrade weapons, but never the ability to upgrade your suit.
Well, yeah, I kind of understand that though, because like, they explain how the blade system works. It scans weapons that you find.
Right.
And so I kind of understand, because you would find weapons all over the place, either by Marines.
But
or...
I mean, there was at least one guy with a friggin', like, similar suit. You know, there could have been...
That is true.
Yeah,
there
could
was
have been
the
more...
bogey.
Yeah, there could have been, like, more of those. Especially since we find out in the end that, spoilers... That guy's just controlling those with his brain, which is why he has those friggin' things around his throne that are just basically probing his mind. And it's like...
It explains why he's like Pinhead if Pinhead removed all the pins.
Yeah. It's like, okay, I get it. But it's like, we could have had more of those then. And you know what? I feel like that would have been a thing. If there was a Vanquish 2, there would have probably been more of those, more
suit
often.
Upgrades.
and you would have, like, killed a bogey and, like, absorbed its suit power.
Or ripped out a chunk of it and shoved it into your suit.
Yeah, and then, like,
They probably maybe, would have made it look really cool.
Yeah, and then maybe fucking Sam could fly, or, like, it would lower your cooldowns, or
yeah,
increase your meter size, something. You know, a lot of
increase
interesting
roll
things.
Distance or something like that, yeah. Which kind of made, you know, thinking about bogeys, thinking about the fact that there won't be a sequel.
Increase armor plating.
Yeah, thinking about how there won't be a sequel, thinking about bogey, everything like that, there is something that I want to touch on, the story.
Okay. I think this is the first time where we've done one of these reviews where we didn't just go straight into the story.
It's not the worst.
What, the story?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
I mean, it's interesting.
It's not only not the worst. I actually rather liked it.
It reflected it, real life in a way.
Yeah. Like, everyone wasn't just two-dimensional. You find out early on that, like, oh, the, I forget her name. I just kept calling her Hillary Clinton.
Yeah.
But you find
the
out...
The president.
The president. The female president. She's not just, like... you find out early on, okay, yeah, she's, like, cut a deal with the Russians or whatever. But it's not, like...
It's not immediately clear what that deal is.
Yeah, it's not immediately clear what that deal is, her motivations or anything... And it's like, okay, this is the typical moment of, like, war to stimulate the economy. That whole, like, idea.
Mm.
And, yeah, all right. And then you find out, like, oh, this whole time your buddy Burns, who seemed really fucking motivated to, like, complete the mission, but he never specifically says what his mission is. You just kind of assume, like, oh, of course, it's to, you know, stop the Russians from taking over the satellite or whatever.
Right.
No, he wants to get in there and he wants to fire the fucking satellite at Moscow and start the war.
Or rather, aggravate the war.
Yeah. Like, he wants a full-blown war to help fucking...
Stimulate the United States economy, which is struggling at the time of the game.
And at the time of the game's creation.
Yeah.
I don't know. At the same time, like, I feel like that's a shitty motivator. They could have had more, like, why is he so driven if it's just about the economy? Why is the economy so fucking bad that they decided to start, like, this elaborate fucking war plot?
And then...
Like, you see that one shot of San Francisco, and it's not like... You don't see a bunch of fucking homeless people. There's no one, like, on the street. The city's not, like, friggin'... I don't know. It's just, like, a bunch of people, like, living their lives like normal people, you know?
Right.
It doesn't seem like... America's on the brink of becoming a third world country or something.
Right.
You know?
But you know, you do find out that Burns is not really all that okay with this mission. He especially isn't okay with seeing so many of his men die, even though he himself is kind of the guy who pulls the trigger on some of them.
Yeah.
On a lot of them.
Yeah. Well, I mean, in the end, like, he... kind of starts killing his own men to protect Sam so that Sam can put an end to this fucking war plot.
Right.
And that's kind of like, okay, Burns, I see what you're going for. The fuck are you going for, though? I understand your motivations. But what the fuck are your motivations again? I don't know. It does have, like, some head-scratchy moments.
Yeah.
There feels like... Again, it's, twists and payoffs without friggin' setups. And... I don't know. I feel like... I kind of want to blame people like fucking M. Night Shyamalan for shit like this.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like everyone's graduated from the fucking Shyamalan school of writing where
they,
it's
they
like...
They really want that big dramatic reveal.
Yeah. And it's like, that's good and all, but you have to have setups. You have to have hints. You have to have moments. Like, if there had been...
What they did sort of hint at, though, you know, from the beginning was the president's involvement somehow with the Russian star, which turned out to be that the United States put the Russian star into power secretly.
Yeah, but then... Yeah. Yeah. But I don't know. It's like... I get a lot more satisfaction out of a plot where it's like... You have that moment of the twist, the big reveal, and it's like... Oh! This whole time, like, that part at the beginning, and that other part...
Yeah.
It was all just building up to this. It was because of this. That... They were doing this thing the whole time. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like, I'd rather, much, much rather have one of those. Rather than friggin', oh, well... I guess she helped the Russian star for some reason. Oh, I guess Burns is gunning down his own men to help Sam because they're friends now? I don't know.
Well, they always kind of had some kind of romance going.
Yeah, it was very strange, very interesting, very weird.
Yeah.
But it's very much just like a bullshit action movie plot. It's the turn off your brain and enjoy the fucking action movie.
Yeah, kind of. It really was.
Yeah.
And with somewhat political intrigue.
Yeah, and you know what? Sometimes I'm okay with that. Like,
This is
a case where it worked, and I feel like it worked well.
It wasn't pretentious about it.
Yeah. It wasn't trying to be more than it was.
Right. And that's something I always appreciate. I always appreciate a game, a movie, a book, whatever. It knows what it is, and it follows through with that. It's like, this is a big... dumb movie about explosions and action stars saying stupid shit, and that's fine.
That's very much what this was. It was so full of one-liners and...
Oh my god.
Like,
to the point we even got the line, very early on in the game, by the way, I'm gonna need a bigger gun.
Yeah.
And we also got some really ridiculous but so satisfying moments, such as when Sam turns himself into a drill to go through the Argus robot. Dean, if you don't play that clip when I say that, I'm going to punch you.
In the butt.
In the butt. Imperial decree. But, yeah, I mean, it's just got, like, those ridiculous moments. And not to mention, one of my very favorite moments in the game, Bogey versus AR suit.
Yeah.
And that punching scene, where you just gotta mash square with all your might as they just... precisely. Followed up by that big old punch. And, oh, God, it's so satisfying. So satisfying. This game just puts a smile on my face, like, all the time. Let's talk about the QTEs.
Okay.
Not a lot of them.
Yes.
Not very hard.
Indeed. In fact, to the point that there are moments where it's like... You feel like maybe there would have been one there, but thankfully there wasn't.
Yeah.
There was none of those, like, Resident Evil 4 moments of... Oh, I guess this cutscene's actually part of the gameplay.
And very seldom are there QTEs that kill you. It's just, if you do them, there's badass payoff.
Yeah.
Like, at the end, there was that QTE.
You know what? I really liked that. I liked the... compared to, like, even Bayonetta, I liked that the QTEs were always during the gameplay. It wasn't like, oh, well, this is an interactive cutscene suddenly. It was like, you're fighting this robot, and then suddenly, oh, it, like, fucking grabs you or something, and you gotta, like, break free, shoot it in the face, and, like...
Kick it in the head.
Yeah. Just something like that, and it's like, okay, that I like. That was awesome.
Yeah.
And at the same time, if you fail, it's not like you're instantly dead. You just take a lot of damage.
Or some of them kill you, some of them don't.
Yeah, yeah. Usually, honestly, sometimes for the instant kills, like the unknown, I would have appreciated a QTE.
Yeah.
Sometimes they're just insta-kills without QTEs, and that bothers me.
The unknown was kind of a horrible thing.
Yeah. I at least like, you know, if they're going to be insta-kills, I like a way to stop that. That would be nice.
Yes. So they were unintrusive, usually had really radical payoffs.
Yeah.
You missed the first one in the game. I may recall that.
Yeah.
What would have happened is Sam would have dodged one projectile.
Yeah.
Then dodged another one spinning the other way.
Uh-huh.
And then finally grabbed the third, turned around, and dunked it back into the hole that it came out of, blowing off the arm.
I remember doing that when I first played the demo back when this game was in development. And that was fucking radical.
It was.
You know what? I hate to admit that, like, fucking... Because that makes me feel shitty. I've owned this game for almost as long as it's been out, and this is the first time I've played it. I haven't... To the point that we played your copy of the game.
Yeah.
Mine is still in shrink wrap.
Still in the shrink wrap. I cannot believe you.
I'm so
sorry. Your system, my game.
Yeah. You freaking... You gave me that copy,
I did. I bought that for you.
That was a fucking, like, birthday present.
You're terrible.
I am the worst. I am the absolute worst.
Absolutely.
That happens so often. That can't be fucking Valkyria. That fucking Valkyria Chronicles still in the shrink wrap.
Yep.
To the point, if we play that, we're gonna end up playing like yours or Dean's copy.
Yeah, probably.
Because at this point, it's like, that's fucking collector's edition. never removed from shrink wrap.
Yep.
But that just goes to show, even me, who was, like, really interested in the game, I never played it.
Didn't pick it up, and then I finally forced you to do it for the show, and, like...
No regrets. Absolutely awesome game.
So good.
I don't know why. I don't know why that happened to this game. It's so sad.
It's really a tragedy, and I kind of wish that there was some kind of way that we could end up with a sequel. Maybe Shinji Mikami, like, just oversees somebody else do it or something. I don't know. Probably not.
That's pretty much, you know,
they
just do, like, a spiritual sequel.
Yeah.
Maybe not quite Vanquish. Maybe it could be, like,
But, like, we're never going to see a continuation of the story. We're never going to get the same mechanics again. We're just never going to see Vanquish 2, and that breaks my heart.
You know what? If it were someone who cares enough about the project to do, like, a decent job of it, to try and hold as much of that original spirit in there, that would be fine.
That would be fantastic. And even if it wasn't Shinji Mikami, even if it was, you know, if it was just Atsuhi Inaba.
Yeah, even if it wasn't Atsuhi Inaba.
Oh, yeah.
So long as it was someone who cared about the project,
yes.
You know? Not one of those, like, cheap fucking cash-in sequels.
Right.
Because that...
We've seen those, we don't like those.
I hate those. I want those to not be a thing.
Dino Crisis 2 was kind of a cash-in sequel.
I don't know about that. Let's not even go there.
Let's not make assumptions.
Okay.
But yeah. Vanquish.
Vanquish.
Solid recommendation from me.
I already gave it my recommendation. I told you people.
Absolutely.
Stop listening to this. Just, you know what? This is pretty much the end of the review. You don't gotta listen to the rest of this. Shut up and go play the game.
Go play it. Go buy. Go buy a new copy. Don't buy used. Go buy a new copy.
Well, maybe let's not go that far.
Oh, come on. It's like $15.
Yeah, but where would you even find one anymore?
Amazon.
Eat a dick. Whatever. The point... buying a new copy is probably not going to get a sequel, man.
Yeah, it's not.
So just go and enjoy...
Just get it.
Just
play it.
Shut. Enjoy the game. Enjoy the game. Go play it for your own self-enjoyment, and because it's just a really rad game.
It is. So I would give this, like I said, solid recommendation.
Yeah. Salad. A salad recommendation.
You stop that. Obviously, though, not for a casual audience. Very much not.
I disagree.
Really?
There's an easy mode, there's friggin' slowdowns, I suck ass at shooters. I don't typically play them, whatever. You can...
The easy mode was called casual.
You can enjoy the game, even if you don't like shooters.
Right. What do you say?
Video game.
Play this game.
Play it. And we'll see you folks next time.
Night, everybody.